Hi, I'm Roger Elmore, Extension Corn Agronomist for Iowa State University, and we're here today to assess kernel set in corn. This is a mid-season, and it's a great time to look at ears and look at kernels and see how well they've pollinated, how well they set, look for aborted kernels, kernels that were never fertilized, and look at some patterns on ears then of how they fill and how they might not be filling. And that all depends on the stress that the crop has received. So let's look at some plants now and see what they look like. You're seeing a lot of firing on the leaves here. Nitrogen loss, potassium. This is a super dry year. Here's some ears that we could pull off and talk about. It's a pretty average year. It's an early planting date, probably first part of April. So the secret to assessing seed set is to husk it very carefully. And we can do that. The idea is to keep the silk intact if you can when you're doing this. This is an early planting date, so it looks like we're almost heading into the dough stage here with this one. So when you get the husks off, then you basically kind of shake it like this and you can assess seed fill pretty easily at this point. A lot of the kernels are denting already, and we have some pretty some aborted kernels up here. The silks that are attached tells you that those seed were never fertilized. That's what we call tipping back. The brown silks are silks that were fertilized and are associated with the seed that are filled out here. So this is, unfortunately, I think the kind of thing that we will get this year, in particular with drought stress, but it can also happen with hail injury, where you lose a lot of leaves right during the silking and pollination time. Nitrogen stress will do this as well. Insect feeding, lots of things can do this. We're seeing a little bit of what might be called a zipper ear, where on the underside of the leaves, we've lost a few more kernels there, both aborted kernels and kernels that were never filled out in the first place. This is a little bit later planting date, probably more like the probably in the middle of May, and we could pull a couple of ears. Look at this one. If you pretty brown silk, you know, two plants away, you have the white silk, but so again, we're going to have a big variation. You can feel the diameter on them. So that's the first test that this ear will have pretty good kernel set. Until the 1950s or so, this is what people ate instead of sweet corn in the States. Just a bit of trivia. Called it roasting ears. And believe it or not, when you pull the ears right at the milk stage, they're just about as sweet as our current sweet corn hybrids. Although it doesn't take too long for them to get old and not very tasty. Again, I'm trying to preserve it so the silks are all attached. Are getting the majority of them attached. Shake test. And again, you know, we're missing some of these tip kernels, and there's some kernels along here that aren't filled, but we don't get any of the zipper. We lost a few right in here, but we're just beyond the milk stage with this. So that would be a good roasting ear to eat. This is field corn though. Let's just pull off this other one. This one right here will be another good case in point. Again, finding out which way these leaves curl around the plant helps. The husks are essentially leaves that cover the ear, so they are photosynthesizing. really small ear. It's got surprising good kernel set. You can see that the silks right in here are attached to kernels that did not fill and will not fill because the pollen source is all gone at this point. But two dramatically different ears, just essentially side by side in the field. It's not, it's very typical of a year with early season problems in terms of emergence and development. Well, we're looking for a pretty normal ear here. We've got a lot of drought stress. We have some nitrogen deficiency, some potassium, but let's pull off an ear here and see how the kernel set has developed. Now, as I look up, we still have a bit of pollen, not much. So we're at the tail end of the pollination period. There's not any pollen, or very little left here at this point. You'll find the smaller ears are a little harder to husk like this. You have to be a lot more careful. Sometimes I use a knife to slice the leaves, and then that makes it a bit easier. You have to be pretty gentle with these little ones. So this was probably just pollinated in the last 2 or 3 days. The length of the silks, by the way, it grows about an inch to inch and a half a day, so we have about 2 days of silk growth there. Once the seed is there, the silk intercepts pollen, it stops, and it fertilizes the seed, then it stops growing. So the silk will only get so long once it's been fertilized. It's like a little hairbrush down here. Let's see how good this seed set on this very new fertilized ear is. So shake test and we'll see that it's pretty good. What you'll see here is some of the silks on the bud of the ear. The first silks that come out from about right where this my right index finger is. So some of the early season, some of the first silks out didn't receive pollen. There's a few along the center and quite a few on the tip. So really considering the situation and how stressed this crop is right now, that's a pretty good seed set. We often always have silk attached on the ends here like this. So not too bad, it's not perfect, but pretty reasonable. We've got reasonable ear length and we have a reasonable girth. What we've tried to explain today is how to assess kernel numbers on corn during the mid-season. And the kernel numbers are affected by a lot of climatic variables and other stresses. So we hope some of the information presented today has been useful. Thank you.